Well, I'd like to welcome from the Hearing Well Club, Tony Berrien, and always good to see you. Welcome.
It's wonderful to be here.
Yes. We're just talking how much we just love this weather. So, now coming up on November 13th, which is it a week from today or two
next
weeks?
Tuesday.
Next Tuesday.
Next
already.
Tuesday.
Wow. You folks will be having your meeting, and tell us about this one. It'll be at the Performing Arts Center, Clubhouse 3.
Yep. It's all going to be about entertainment.
Yeah.
One of the problems that many people have is hearing well in the theater.
Yeah, yeah.
The plays. And so we're going to talk about how you can improve your hearing or how with assistive technology. So the Sedgestrom representative will be there. We have somebody coming from the Laguna Playhouse. This is their first time. I'm really excited about it. They recently got a grant that allows them to have captioned performances. So we're
Laguna Playhouse?
Yeah.
Oh, great.
Yeah, once a month they have a I just went last Saturday. We saw a seafarer. So a little salty. But it was good. The acting was phenomenal.
No, they do great stuff down there.
Yeah.
They really do.
And we're going to be talking about assistive technology at the Edwards Theater. That's a Regal.
Yeah.
And also the Regency. And what's going to be different about this time is we're going to have a raffle because there's going to be tickets.
Oh, there you go.
So, you know, tickets at the Sedgestrom and Laguna Playhouse, you know, it's just be fabulous to get complimentary tickets for the play of your choice. As a matter of fact, we're kind of planning to have a special event, get a van, and go in January to see Driving Miss Daisy.
Oh, so it's going to be
at the Laguna Playhouse.
That'll be good.
I'd like to do that as a group. So we're going to introduce that at our next meeting.
Hey, I have a question for you.
Sure.
Along these same lines here. When you go to the theater nowadays, standard movie theater, most of the popular ones, the big blockbuster type action adventure, Marvel and things like that, very loud sounds. Mm. Even for us, even for my daughter, you know, you'll see her sometimes covering her ears, but these are the type of movies that most people go and see nowadays, these really high energy type movies.
I'll tell you, the hearing aid industry loves that.
Yeah, I bet they do, because even, you know, I notice it sometimes, and you know exactly what I'm talking about, but my question is, how does that affect people who are using some sort of a hearing device? Do they have to turn that down? Does it make them hear better? I don't know.
You can.
Because louder doesn't mean better.
You can adjust the volume, yes. The problem with the sound, if it's too loud, and you're wearing some kind of aid or cochlear implant, is that it really puts, there's a lot of reverberation in the room.
Okay, right,
because
right.
Those instruments have microphones in them, and they're just, it's amplifying everything.
Yeah.
And you can only just dial back just so much. So if you use an assistive technology, if you use a receiver that they can provide, you can adjust the volume. You know, I know hearing people that are now using assistive technology just for that purpose.
Yeah, because, I can understand.
Because noise-induced hearing loss is a possibility if you expose yourself to a lot of loud noises, especially over 15 minutes, 30 minutes. The more time you spend in that explosive kind of sound, the more chance you have of hurting your hearing.
Well, I remember going to concerts back in the late 70s, early 80s.
See this?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is noise-induced hearing loss.
You went to a lot of concerts?
You don't have to go to a lot. You just have to go to one.
Yeah. Well, you know what I was going to say is a lot of times you'd go to these concerts, and concerts used to be a lot longer back then. You know, they could be up to 3 hours. And after you left the arena, especially if it was indoor, your ears would be ringing.
I know where
And
you're
as
going.
A kid, I used to think, we used to go, oh, it wasn't a good concert unless your ears are ringing at the end. Of course, we didn't know any better.
That's dangerous.
Yeah.
It's so dangerous. So anyway, and like I said, the hearing aid dispensers and an audiologist, they love it because your hearing diminishes and then you need to get hearing aids.
I like the idea of going to a theater and maybe to the point, even if people have perfect hearing, putting in earphones and connecting it to your to your phone or something and maybe controlling it.
Yes.
That would be great. I like that. Yeah.
So, but I would I'd like to, separate from this, I would like to throw in one other thing. We had a fabulous meeting, it was a bonus meeting, it was an extra special event last Thursday, and we video recorded it, and it's on our website, and it's about hearing aids and hearing loops.
Oh, great. Good,
and
good.
I had a phenomenal speaker come from Wisconsin, so it's a doctor of audiology, and she wasn't selling anything, and she just talks pure truth, and she's wonderful. And I've already gotten a lot of feedback that they've really enjoyed the videos. You know, we try to videotape all of our meetings and put them on our website.
And of course, very easy, hearingwellclub.com.
Exactly.
There you go.
Exactly.
That's good. I'll send it to my father-in-law. All right. I want to thank you for coming on. This is great. This is really going to be a neat
meeting.
The holiday
time, you know, people have a little extra time to go entertainment and all. So
all are invited.
Yep.
Okay. Very good. So that is next Tuesday at the Performing Arts Center. Doors open at 1:45. So be there and maybe you'll win something. But even if you don't, you're going to get a lot of good information about when you go to these theaters, movie theaters, legitimate theaters, whatever they might be. I think this is really good.
Yeah.
Very nice. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You take care of yourself.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. Yeah, but that's so true.